Money and welcome to the Extreme TIG channel. So for today's video, guys, I'm going to show you one tip for the overhead tight gap, how you put your root in if you don't want to use grinder. I'm just going to show you an example of this 6-inch carbon pipe. As I said, this is a overhead tight gap, how you want to force your filler wire in without using grinder. There is a technique for that. It's not about cranking the argon gas too much, so it's gonna push your puddle. That's a myth. That's not gonna happen unless you're using argon on your air compressor, and even in that case it's gonna be hard to accomplish. It's about amps, it's about your inclination, your manipulation of your torch and inclination of your filler wire. As I said, I'm a 1/8 guy. There is a reason why I'm always like to use 1/8. I always want to have heavy root, heavy buildup. First and foremost, it's to prevent any sagbag, especially on stuff like this. Using grinder also, as I said, depends from a field weld, from position. If it's really tight spot, you don't want to have grinder close to your head, or just want to avoid that and make your life easier. Just use this little tip I'm going to show you. It's about cranking the amps and feeding that rod in, forcing that filler wire with pushing. You can walk the cup the way how you like it. As I said, it's like a keyhole technique, burning edges and pushing that rod in. And you can freehand as well, whatever it's easier for you, whatever you like, whatever your technique prefer. Travel speed also one of the most important things. You have to adjust your travel speed, or depends how much amps you can handle, and fitting your fitting hand the way how you feed that filler wire. This is just a little to show you how I position myself. And once I burn edges, once I connect, I'm just forcing by pushing that filler wire in. As I said, this is a keyhole technique. Don't pause too much. It's a little bit faster, 125 amps. It's not that hot. You can go even a little bit harder, but for this pipe, for this wall thickness, 125 is good enough. Opens the both sides enough to feed that filler wire in and push to have enough buildup inside the root. The most crucial part here is the 6 o'clock. That couple inches on both sides of the pipe, when you start on at the 6 o'clock at the bottom, that's most important, especially later for hot pass. One of the reasons why I don't like use 332 is you can't push that much, especially if you force with 125 amps. You're gonna just melt that rod. It's gonna be concave. It's gonna be a little bit, maybe even less, with a surface, and then later with a hot pass, you're gonna have a concave root, which leads to X-ray failure or whatever. But as I said, that's why I like 1/8. Even if it's flush with the material, a little bit. In this case, as I'm gonna show you later, it's gonna be a little bit above surface. And I have even more material inside the bevel, which is gonna help me later when I do hot pass to prevent sagback. Okay, this part is done. As you can see, the bottom is that 6 o'clock. Especially pay attention on that, focus on that 6 o'clock. This is the most crucial part, and that's good enough. It's a little bit above surface, that's really good. And as you're going up, it's already, you have nice good buildup. And I'm just gonna go, just continue on the, I'll push on the other side of the pipe. Once you connect, don't pause too much. As soon as you start melting that puddle, then you start adding rod by just and pushing it in. As soon as you open that keyhole, you start pushing in. This is from the outside. As I said, it's a keyhole technique, so it's a little bit different. It's a little bit different pattern. And once you can always grind stop starts, if that's gonna help you. I'm not gonna do that in this case. I'm just gonna start strike on a push back a little bit on that on the bottom, and as soon as you start melting, just start pushing that rub. Even if you go as I said, even if it's 332, you know, you can and then you got higher with amps than what you usually do, and then you can have a cold wire, you know, you can have just stubs in, they're not melted, and same thing can happen with 1/8 as well, don't get me wrong, but in this case, if you just push in the pedal and you're pushing from the bottom inside, you should be good. And now as you're going up on the side, it's getting easier. Those the most critical part is that 6 inch the 6 o'clock on the bottom, couple inches on both sides. As soon as you pass that, you should be golden. You shouldn't have any problems. And I'm just gonna continue on. As I said, the gap is different on this pipe. Made that on purpose to have really tight on the bottom, because usually you're gonna have tight. It's not gonna be tighter than 2 mil. But in case if that happened, there you go. One of the tips that it might help you without using grinder or without switching to smaller rod, which is doable as well. But still, you wanna be on a safe page, on a safe side. That's why I like 1/8. Always gonna give you perfect amount. If you got bigger gap on the side, you can always lower down your amps and then switch side to side. You switch to dipping technique. This is what I always like to do, especially if it's gap getting a little bit bigger. You gonna slow down with amps and just dip sides. Dipping technique is one of the best for me. It's all about habit and personal preference. What do you like? What are you used to? I like dipping technique. Especially, you know, you control everything pretty much here. You got both sides burned. You can see the edges, they're opening up. So you control the feed, the speed, the amount of material, how much you depositing in, and you're on your safe side, you're on a safe page, especially for the X-ray. So as I said, you always, if it's a bigger gap, slow down, go down on the amps. Okay, now that's it pretty much for the root. I'm not gonna go all pipe, just that bottom section, that's most crucial one. That's everybody, lots of people got issue with that, so this is one of the reasons why I made this video. And okay, this is 6 o'clock. Pay attention on that 6 o'clock. It's a little bit above the surface, so I'm gonna continue on. I'm gonna do hot pass, continue with 1/8, but I'm gonna go up on 160 amps, just to show you guys what's gonna happen with the root. Okay, I'm gonna go a little bit heavier here. I'm doing pretty much root and what I'm gonna do with the hot pass and a filler. It's gonna be pretty much heavier fill, just to see what's gonna happen to a root. Just stretching side to side, trying to do a build up as much as I can. Okay, that's it. That's the bottom section. As I said, I only did 6 to 8 o'clock and 6 to 4 o'clock here. Just the bottom part. And now we're gonna see what's gonna happen to a root. Pretty much nothing. Sides are still the same. No sag back here. And at 6 o'clock, as I said, pay attention here. It's the same. Didn't change at all. That's it pretty much, guys. I hope I help you with that tip. As I said, if you don't like grinder, if you're in a really tight spot, just try to play with your amps and filler wire. That's it. See you in the next one, guys. Take care.